좋아하는
Yes, sir.
Thank you. if they go home during the service, they will be confiscated. We turn to you at the end of the service for a fee.
Oh, my friend, I'm going to be
a wonderful human being. Also wanted to acknowledge Kedua. One who shared many wonderful moments with her. Simone Boyce. So, let me invite this woman, dear at this time, to come and share the union with us.
Is it any wonder that St. John maintained the to the home. And she was loved by her family, friends, and children. Her caregiver Simone, whose mobile contact contains precious memories of her. Her neighbors, Dr. Young's family, who became anxious if they must see her for an extended length of time. Having taken this journey through the pages of Cynthia's life, I feel sure that she will agree with the colleagues. Her mother's maiden name was Queen. She came to be a queen. She's royal. She will be greatly missed by us.
Thank you so much. So, my dear, it is time. I just wanted to put you to bed. Inviting us to share very quickly, briefly, something about what you remember about our dear sister. Come. And the other person, please be ready to share.
To supersede and to help him and the conduct of the affairs at the Princeton Methodist Church. And it was at that time that I first got to know St. Jeff. And from then up until now, all the memories that I have of her are really pleasant memories of how hardworking she was, always present in the church activities, whether it be a Bible study or any fair or any fundraising event that we may have had. And she put her hands willingly together to make things work together with the other members of the society. Must say that over the years, one of the things that really stuck out for me was a pleasant personality in all things. I can't remember how I ever quarreling with anybody. And she would give her ideas and talk out and be always pleasant. So I think that's a good message for all of us to be able to be ready to socialize with others and to share your knowledge and your ability. So very happy, and I praise God and thank Him for giving me the privilege of knowing Cynthia over the past years. Thank you.
Thank you very much, my brother. Continue to celebrate the life of the dearly departed Cynthia. We're going now to the Word of God. What is God saying to us through His Word? The readings are Psalm 23. The epistle comes to us from Romans 8, 51 to 59.
What are we to say about these things? If God is will be able to separate us from the love of God in Christ Jesus our Lord. This is the word of God.
Amen. Thanks be to God. Thank you so much, sister. Now I invite us to stand for the reading of the Gospel, which comes to us from the Gospel of John, chapter 11. We read from verse 17 through to verse 27. We say, "Glory to you, O God." John chapter 11, reading from verse 17 through to verse 27. The raising of Lazarus. When Jesus arrived, he found that Lazarus had already been in the tomb 4 days. Now Bethany was near Jerusalem, some 2 miles away. And many of the Jews had come to Martha and Mary to console them about their brother. When Martha heard that Jesus was coming, she went and met him, while Mary stayed at home. Martha said to Jesus, "Lord, if you had been here, my brother would not have died. But even now I know that God will give you whatever you ask of him." Jesus said to her, "Your brother will rise again." Martha said to him, "I know that he will rise again in the resurrection on the last day." And Jesus said to her, "I am the resurrection and the life. Those who believe in me, even though they die, will live. And everyone who lives and believes in me will never die. Do you believe this?" She said to him, "Yes, Lord, I believe that you are the Messiah, the Son of God, the one coming into the world." Beloved, this is the Gospel of Christ. Praise be to Christ, our Lord. We sing the hymn, "Blessed Assurance, Jesus is Mine."
Thank you.
very, very good advice. I hope she remembers the advice that Cynthia would give her. But Sister Cynthia was listening. Sister Cynthia would tell you exactly, but you know that better than me, exactly like this. Now, the Princess of Methodist Church is a large building, but a very small congregation. And you know when Sister Cynthia is not well, because you miss her. But once she is well, even if she's feeling 25% good, you are sure to see her. She was a good trooper. She was a faithful person. She had a steady hand, and she had a good mind. So, as a pastor, a listener, and because the congregation is so small, the rest of the members will miss her. Because you know, if in a large place, if one person is missing, it might sound right. But in a small gathering, if one person is missing, you will sure miss that person. But we miss her. But my dear friends, we will miss her, yes. And I mourn with the family. I mourn with them. But I want to celebrate even more her life. God didn't have to, he lent her to us for all of 87 years. And as I was sharing last night at the prayer meeting with you gathered, you know you can't satisfy your human needs. She made it up to 87. I am sure that we were thinking, okay, when Sister Sylvia, Cynthia meet at 90, we'll have a good celebration. And then if she would have made at 90, you know what you would say? I wonder if she can make it to 95, or maybe she would have made it to 95. You know, we can't satisfy the same God. I wonder if she can make it to 100. You know, we can never be satisfied, but my friends, our time and God's time are different. We have different agendas. God's timing is perfect. Our timing and our schedule could be a bit selfish. We would want to keep Sister Cynthia here in this state forever. But God in his goodness and mercy and his immutable wisdom said, Cynthia, you have done your part. Now it's time for you to return to me. For those persons who are involved in sports, cricket and football and so on, you know, sometimes you might be having the time of your life. You might be having a football field, you might be having the best game of your life. But you might do some kind of infraction. And when the referee reaches in his pocket for that red card, as good as you are, as good a game as you are having, when he pulls out that red card and places it in the air, like places it in front of your face like this, what does it mean? You have to what? You have to leave the field of play. I have never seen, in all my years of playing sport and watching sports, I have never seen a referee take out a red card, at least before they had the review system and so on. I've never seen him take out a red card and the person's going pleading with him. And he changes his mind. Once you get that red card, it means that you're off the field of play. You might be having the best innings of your life as a batsman. And of course, it just takes one ball, one well-delivered ball, to beat you and out you. You might be having the best innings of your life. And sometimes, my dear friends, you might even really be out. But before they had the review system, once the umpire raises that finger, what does it mean? They have to put it back on their arm and head it to the pavilion. God's timing is perfect. He decided that it was time for Sister Cynthia to leave the field of play and to come and join him in the pavilion where there is now the cloud of witnesses, cheering on those of us who believe in Him. There is something. Jesus is never too early or never too late. Yes, in 87 wanted her to have more, but He's never too early and never too late. Even He's always on time. Even when He is 4 days late, He is still on time. Think about how the sisters of Lazarus would have been feeling. He had gotten a message that the one we love is sick. Jesus, although He was about just 2 days, 2 miles away, He did not go to Lazarus. Then He said, okay, we're going to Lazarus. He said, well, Lord, they almost wanted to kill you there. You're going back there? He said, well, yeah, man. I'm going to wake up Lazarus. He said, but if Lazarus is sleeping, then you'll wake up. He said, you know, Lazarus is actually dead. So Jesus and His disciples, they began to make their way back to Bethany, where Lazarus is. And from a distance of, you know, news guy, they had a good system. Now, they didn't have cell phones and so on, or telephones, but they had a good system of relaying messages. Somebody said that Jesus is coming in the distance. And Martha, always busy, doesn't wait. She gets up and she goes to Jesus. And He said, Lord, I do not know if this was a kind of remonstration, if it was an accusation, Lord, you know something. If you had been here, if you had responded to the distress call that I sent out to you, you know, my brother would still have been alive. Jesus said, Martha, don't worry, you know. She would rise again. She said, yes, Lord, I know that you will rise again on the last day. He said, Martha, listen. I am. Now, to translate it from the Greek, the literal translation is, I am the resurrection and the life. Now, He didn't say that I will be the resurrection and the life. Jesus was talking in the present tense. He said, I am, and it's an emphatic I am the resurrection and the life. Those who die will live again. Those who die believing in me will rise again. I don't know how much comfort that gives me, or how much comfort that gives us. But my dear friends, as followers of Jesus Christ, that is how we live. We live believing that this life is not all that there is to it. Paul, in talking and writing to the church at Corinth, many members believed that they didn't believe in the resurrection of the body. They had a feeling, and they lived that way. When you're dead, you're done. Paul said, listen, if for this life only we have hope, then we have all persons most to be pitied. Because what Moses said? Moses said, the years in Psalm 90, one of the few Psalms not actually attributed to the psalmist David, but actually this one is attributed to Moses. For the years of a man's life, or a person's life, at least 4 years and 10, and if by reason of strength may be forceful, yet their life is really just a blink in eternity. Of course, Sister Cynthia lived up to 87. So she had 4 score years. So she had what? She had 3 score years and 10. So she was strong. Then she was extra strong because she had 10 more years, which is 80, and then for Lania, she had 7 more years added on to her. So she was a particularly strong one. 87 years. If more West Indies batsmen would make 87, we'd be in a better shape, we'd be in better shape today. But here it is, my dear friends. Jesus, I am the resurrection and life. He's talking with the presence. Those who die believing in will rise again. And that is what keeps us going, my dear friends. This existence is not the only existence. There is an existence even after this. So, how must we live our lives? Knowing, my dear friends, that this is not all to life. How must we live our lives? This life is brief. We must live our lives looking unto Jesus, the author and finisher of our faith. We must live our lives, my dear friends, this brief life that we have. We must live our lives seeking peace, seeking harmony with one another, seeking to tell others, listen, you can accumulate whatever you want, but you can't take it with you. Trying to accumulate riches, spending all our time accumulating riches, I want to say, is a waste of time. You know, don't remember the parable of the rich man? He had an abundant harvest. And he said, you know something, boy? I have some great. He never even gave thanks to God. He never acknowledged God in his reckoning. And he said, listen, you know what I'll do? What will I do with all these goods? You know what? I'll break down my barns. I will build bigger ones. And I'll store my goods and so on in the barns. And then I'll kick back and relax and say, Soul, he said, buddy, he said, Soul, you have goods laid up for many years. Eat, drink, and be merry. Now, it was just a thought, eh? He was just thinking in his mind. Then God said, you fool. This very night, the same soul that will say, eat, drink, and be merry, that same soul is being tired of you. And what will you do with all that you have acquired? One of my lecturers, Theological College in Jamaica, his spouse would say, she has never seen a hearse with a trailer behind it. You know what it means, my dear friends? When we put our dear sister Cynthia in the grave, out of a church cemetery in Manhattan Road. It's just the body and the casket and the flowers and so on, well, the flowers. And the dirt will be going in. That's it. If you put anything else, my dear friends, you know, you're just wasting time. So how to spend our lives? How do we live our lives? Let us live our lives looking unto Jesus. Author and finisher of. Let us live our life believing in Him and say, Lord, I believe in you. You will take care of this. Last night I talked about saying goodbye to our dearly departed sister in confidence. We are sure, my dear friend, we know where she has gone. And she has gone there. Not necessarily because she was a good position, she was a good person. But like all of us have sinned and have fallen short of the glory of God. But it's because of God's grace that she's going to be with Him. All of us have sinned and have fallen short of the glory of God. But it is the blood of Jesus that has settled the account that we have a long time ago. On the cross of Calvary. Those who die in believing in Christ will live again. So my dear sister Cynthia, we thank God for your life. We thank God for the way that you live. And we thank God for the legacy that you are leaving. May God bless your children, extended family, your friends, the members of your faith community. In the name of the Father, of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. We sing that great hymn of faith and praise, How Great Thou Art.
Thank you.
praise and thanksgiving to you, O Christ, our Lord and our God, who have overcome the sharpness of death and over the kingdom of heaven for all believers, and are now seated at the right hand of God in the glory of the Father. Praise and blessing to you, O Holy Spirit, God our Comforter, who bear witness within us of our acceptance with the Father, and have become the pledge of our eternal heavens. All praise and glory, blessing and honor, thanksgiving and worship be to you, O blessed Trinity, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever. Amen. We bless your name for the life of Cynthia, whom we today need to rest. We give you thanks for the joy and blessing her life has brought to others, for her service to the generation according to your will, and for every happy remembrance of her life. We bless you for your mercy and goodness which have attended her all the days of her life, that now the trials of this world are over and death itself is past. Receive her into your perfect kingdom, and bring us with all who have lived and served you faithfully to the fullness of your eternal joy. Through Jesus Christ, our Lord, we all say, offer you a part of your gracious gift.
standing for the implementation.
Thank you. Let us pray. A gracious God has been here ready to leave this sanctuary and make a way for you to find a resting place for you. The remains of their departed sister. Pray, O God, that you go with us. Thank you, O God, for all those who have had the execution of this service. Thank you, O God, for the position. Thank you, O God, for the multimedia arrangement. Thank you for those who have read and for those who want to have presented the eulogy, for those who have supported. Now the word of peace to God again from the day of the Lord Jesus Christ, the great shepherd of the sheep and the blood of the eternal covenant. May be perfect in every good thing to do his will, working in us that which is well pleasing in his sight. Through Jesus Christ, who be in glory forever and ever. Amen. Also, we will come to the one who will allow persons to join from all over the world. Thank you. We recess in this way. I will lead off session, followed by the casket, which is the burial casket, immediate family members. For the rest of us will exit the sanctuary as orderly as possible. We get into our vehicles or bikes, or if you're walking, we make our way up to the burial.
Thank you. and this will see where we draw God.
Tôi có màu đấy. Không có được.
Chúng ta về stay mà.
Yo.
Không làm mấy hỏi gì đâu mà.
Excuse me. Yeah.
Yeah, well, I'm going to put on this body by a certain time.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
Go down after a certain time. Yeah,
yeah.
So, yeah. Yeah.
Okay.
kam, derang kam.
Derang orang itu. Itu ya dong.
Huh?
And you concerned about
no,
this?
No, I don't concern not at all. I assistant.
That's all. How are you? Release on you.
Oh.
Right, you're holding it. You're holding it hard, eh?
Yes, man.
Alright, we only box here.
You are a chef somebody and control.
Cool, help you.
Now I can help you. Take it over there.
Yeah, you take it. You take it.
Mean?
I know that because we have helped something. I'm saying, yeah, man. Yeah.
You will miss. Balance the box. Let somebody go in the center of the box and raise the box. Now hold it straight. Raise the box from underneath. Pull it on it, right? Have you ready to hold it? Hold like you now, eh? Pull to you. Yeah, pull it, boy. All over down. Go down. Go down with the back.
Foot first.
Go down with the foot.
Body foot.
All right, pretty much.
We're brought today. What remains of the departed sister to its final resting place? We are still in an attitude of worship. So we know that neither death nor life, nor things present, nor things to come, nor height, nor depth, nor any other creature can separate us from the love of God which is in Jesus Christ our Lord. A building from God, a house not made with hands, eternal in the heaven. Since our sister Cynthia has departed out of this life, and Almighty God in His mercy has taken her to Himself, we therefore commit her body to the ground, dust to dust, our sister ashes and to earth, in the sure and certain hope of the resurrection to eternal life. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, we say, Amen. A reading from Luke chapter 1, 68-79. It's called the Benedictus. And had raised up a mighty salvation for us in the house of his servant David, as he spake by the mouth of his holy prophets, which have been since the world began, that we should be saved from our enemies and from the hand of all that hate us, to perform the mercy of his holy covenant he would give us, that we being delivered out of the hand of our enemies might serve him without fear, in holiness and righteousness before him all the days of our life. And thou, child, shall be called the prophet of the highest, for thou shalt go before the face of the Lord to prepare his ways, give knowledge of salvation unto his people for the remission of their sins, through the tender mercy of our God, whereby the day spring from on high hath visited us, to give light to them that sit in darkness and in the shadow of death, and to guide our feet into the way of peace. Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, as it was in the beginning, is now, and ever shall be, world without end. Amen. I heard a voice from heaven saying unto me, from henceforth, blessed are the dead who die in the Lord, even so says the Spirit, for they rest from their labors. Going to pray three short petitions. After each petition, When I pray the words through our Lord Jesus Christ, I want us to respond with a resounding amen. Amen?
Amen.
It sounds a little thanky-fanky, but when we actually begin, the voice must raise the dead. That amen. So let us pray. O merciful God, the Father of our Lord Jesus Christ, Father of mercies and God of all comfort, from death of sin to the new life of righteousness, that when we shall depart this life, we shall be found acceptable in your sight. Let me pray through Jesus Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Grant to the bereaved consolation and faith in this time of distress and trial, the blessed hope in the coming of your kingdom, and the sustaining grace in the fellowship of your people, and steadfastness in the service of your name and the doing of your will. Through Jesus Christ our Lord, we say,
Amen.
Oh, support us, O Lord, all the day long of this troublous life, until the shadows lengthen, the evening comes, the busy world is hushed, the fever of life is over, and our work is done. Then, Lord, in your mercy, grant unto us safe lodging, holy rest, and peace at the last. Through Jesus Christ our Lord, we say,
Amen. Amen.
Okay, we have some sheets available. Have one you can get. Well, sing the wondrous love of Jesus, sing his mercy and his grace. In the mansion bright and blessed, he prepared for us a place. Oh, when we all must get to heaven, what a day of rejoicing that will be. When we all see Jesus, we will sing and shout the victory while we walk, the pilgrim's pathway. Clouds will over spread the sky, but when traveling days are over, not a shadow, not a sight. When we all get to heaven, what a day. When we all see Jesus, we will sing and shout the victory. Let us then be true and faithful, trusting, serving every day. Just one glimpse of him in glory will the toils of life we pay. When we all get to heaven, what a day of rejoicing that will be. When we all see Jesus, we will sing and shout the victory. Onward to the bright before us, soon his beauty will behold. Soon the pearly gates will open, we shall tread the streets of gold. When we all get to heaven, what a day of rejoicing that will be. Oh, when we all see Jesus, we will sing and shout the victory. When we all get to heaven, what a day of rejoicing that will be. When we all see Jesus, we will sing and shout the victory. Just want to walk a little closer with Jesus. Just a closer walk with thee. Granted, Jesus is my plea. Daily walking close to thee, let it be.
me from all wrong. I'll be satisfied as long as I walk, let me walk close to thee. Just a closer walk with thee.
Oh, just a closer walk with thee.
Granted, Jesus is my plea. Daily walking close to thee. Let it be, dear Lord, let it be. Through this world's apologies, if I falter, Lord, who cares? Who with me my burden shares? None but thee, dear Lord, none but thee. Just a closer walk with thee.
Oh, just a closer walk with thee.
Granted, Jesus is my plea. Daily walking close with thee. Let it be, dear Lord, let it be. When my feeble life is o'er, safely off to thy kingdom shore, to thy shore, where just a closer walk with thee.
Oh, just a closer walk with thee.
Granted, Jesus is my plea. Daily walking close to thee. Let it be, dear Lord, let it be. Let it be, dear Lord, let it be. One more time, let it be, dear Lord, let it be.
When the trumpet of the Lord shall sound, when the roll is called up yonder, we want to be there, I'm sure.
When the trumpet of the Lord shall sound, and time shall be no more, and the morning breaks eternal bright and fair, when the saved earth shall gather over on the other shore, and the roll is called up yonder, I'll be there. When the roll is called up yonder, 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 I'll be there.
On that bright and cloudless morning, when the heaven flesh shall rise, and the glory of his resurrection shed,
when his chosen ones shall gather to their home beyond the skies, and the roll is called up yonder, I'll be there. Oh, when the roll is called up yonder, when the roll is called up yonder, when the roll is called up yonder, when the roll is called up for his wondrous love and care, then when all of life is over and the work on earth is done, when the roll is called up yonder, I'll be there. When the roll is called up yonder, 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 I'll be there.
Last verse again. Let us labor for the Master from the dawn till setting sun. Let us fall in
love. When all of the when the roll is called up yonder, when the roll is called up yonder, when the roll. road is called up yonder. Bend the road is called up yonder. I'll be there.
Oh, bend the road
is called up yonder. Bend the road is called up yonder. Bend the road is called up yonder. I'll be there.
What have our eyes seen?
Mine eyes have seen the glory of the coming of the Lord. He is trampling out the vintage where the grapes of wrath are stored. He has loosed the fateful lightning of his terrible swift sword. Earth's truth is marching on.
Glory!
Glory!